this is the Human Rights Commission meeting. It's June 28th. It was called to order at 5:38, and the filming started at 5:53. So we are discussing our proposal to bring our civility pledge and resolution to the City Council. Elisa, if you could again, Phil, just be our expert on the council process. Is there a preference in terms of how the council does its work, whether it is there's a presentation from the public or you know, presented through you?
I don't know about the preference so much, but again, because it's the Human Rights Commission's kind of baby, mm-hmm. I would love to have it on the agenda. I actually would have to consult with Bill Dwight as the president who creates the agenda, because
yes.
I think it's important for the Human Rights Commission to kind of present it, since it was initiated here, but it also needs to be on the agenda as something that the council votes on. So I'm not quite sure what that would look like. I think probably technically it should just be from the council, and we'll recognize the Human Rights Commission, and you can do a presentation after you've been recognized, I suspect. But I'll check with Bill just to be sure.
And that's happening in July?
July 13th. July 13th. So the council could take first reading at that meeting.
Right.
And there's no August meeting?
There is an August meeting, but we wouldn't do the second reading until August.
Right.
I won't be able to be present.
Okay.
What time should we attend that council meeting?
Resolutions are kind of the second to third thing on the agenda. If we don't have a lot of public comment, the meeting gets going pretty close to 7.
I'm sorry, what's the date of that again?
The 13th.
And then the mayor does his proclamations and notices, whatever. So usually the first vote is around, the first resolutions come up around 7:10, 7:15, but
okay.
Again, it depends on how much public comment there is.
And I will be out of town.
Okay, that's fine.
I mean, it's safe to get there by 7:05, I would say, just in case things go really quickly. And in the summer, things we have light agendas, so things do tend to go quickly.
So there'll be, I can be there that day as well. So there will be enough of us to.
And that's in here?
Yes. Okay, so that's how we get it to in front of the City Council, and we hope that the council will see fit to adopt the resolution. Then we're going to launch it more broadly in September. So some of the things that have come up in discussion already were inviting schools to take the resolution to participate in some way, faith communities, the business community, and Chamber of Commerce. There was an idea that we should have an op-ed in the newspaper before it gets fully launched to anticipate its launch. And it was also suggested that we might want to develop a set of talking points for people who might inevitably respond cynically to the resolution once it's made public. And this is our opportunity to talk about how we would like to advance it once it's approved by the council and introduce it to the community at large.
I thought it was a pretty good starting point that was in the email.
Yeah.
Posted on the website, certainly, the mm-hmm. city's website.
I would like to see if maybe we can make a concerted effort to perhaps meet with the superintendent and see if there's a way we can incorporate this or they might want to buy into the right word, but somehow have it distributed to the schools. Give them that option, not necessarily have a plan for them,
right.
Tell them how to do it, but just say we would love to have your participation, because I just think it would be great to get it to the high school and the grade school.
Right.
And also Smith, you know, I mean, that would be great.
Anyone know, would you address the office of the president at Smith?
Yes, yeah, you would. I would think. I think that's where you would start. They would probably, she would probably shuffle it off to maybe the head of the social work or whatever, but.
Will this be on letterhead from the city if it's approved by the city council?
Would it be on one of those parchment papers?
So I'm thinking about posting it, the practicality of having it be, I'm thinking about branding, really. How do we brand this as what does it look like that we're handing this thing out so that people know what they're seeing? So it's all the same. So wherever we put it, wherever we send it, it stands out as the civility pledge. So I just wondered if the city seal goes on it or something of that nature.
Well, actually, it's proclamations that are on the parchment.
We used to do both, isn't it? Just
resolutions from the city council.
Oh, okay.
Tend to be. We don't actually have hard copies at this point. It's all digitized, and there's a page. But we can do anything we want with it, and I'm sure there's not a problem putting the letterhead on it and so forth. You can look at resolutions that have been passed by the city council to see what they look like.
I would just like to do a really good job of branding it before we start to think about that it's always the same and it's on a certain color paper or something like that. That really makes it unique unto itself.
Mm-hmm. I'll ask the mayor about that tomorrow. How do you
say
excuse me, post the pledge somewhere accessible, maybe HLC page on city website seeking signers. I mean, are we hoping it will go out as a city proclamation or a human rights commission? I mean, are we keeping them separate or are we putting it in together?
It's a little murky because we are a commission of the city government, but I think it's a resolution. I think the project belongs to the Human Rights Commission, and through the resolution process, we're asking our elected officials for their endorsement.
Okay.
But that brings up a good point that I would think somewhere on this, we've got to have Human Rights Commission.
So I was just working to put it together the way that the council would need it as a resolution. And I am concerned, and it makes me think maybe you don't want to get the council to pass it as a resolution, because when the council passes it, it has to be a resolution of the council. And the council would say, in city council date, upon the recommendation of Councillor da 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 da, Councillor da 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 da, Councillor da 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 da, Northampton Mayor David J. Narkowitz, if he agrees, and the Human Rights Commission. That's the standard form in which the resolution has to be created for the City Council. So if you guys want to do it differently and do it just as a resolution of the HRC, and then somehow even write into the body of it, maybe change the body that says, we could do a separate resolution, the council. So this is getting a little convoluted, but I think it's the only way technically it can be done. And then you could have in one of your whereases, whereas a companion resolution was passed by the Northampton City Council endorsing this, was passed on July 13, 2000, da da da, and do it that way so that you guys own it more. But I do think that if it becomes a shared resolution, then it would probably end up taking this form where the city council is.
I don't have a problem with it being a shared resolution. I mean, in fact, it, quite frankly, in my mind, it no offense to us, but it gives a lot more clout if it's coming from the city. Yeah. My whole thought was just as long as our name was in there, and like you mentioned it.
Well, our name is in the resolution itself. It says, be it further resolved that the Human Rights Commission invites all members of the Northampton community to join a civility pledge.
I didn't even think, okay, yeah, I mean, that's all I meant. I personally would rather have it as a city resolution.
So we would have to change that body and not have it be that it's an invitation from us.
we?
It seems like technically we need to say, but we could put the HRC first and say, you know, by invitation of the Human Rights Commission, the Northampton City Council, and then hopefully the Northampton Mayor, da-da-da-da-da.
And does something like this, a resolution, and as you show it on your screen, it's just writing alone. First, to me, it'd be nice if it had a nice, fancy Northampton seal on the top.
No, it will, but this is, I'm just writing it out so that I can see it.
But it will get that.
When it becomes, when it is voted on and ratified, then it gets put onto a city. I'll pull up the city's website of resolutions so you can see a sample of what they look like.
So it doesn't have to say this, be it further resolved that the Human Rights Commission invites all members of the Northampton community to join in signing a civility pledge, signing in of an intention. It could be, we just, in the Northampton community is invited.
Right, right.
Does it have to say who it's from? Not you, not us, not the mayor, it doesn't have to say the long list.
Right.
It can be more simplified.
Right.
And I think the simpler the better, because we're gonna lose people.
Exactly.
Oh, yes.
Exactly. Yeah.
This
I mean, as long as it says at the top, this Northampton City Council and the Human Rights Commission, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's the most
this?
Important thing.
Yeah.
Yes.
So it's got the city seal at the top, and there's a very particular format that resolutions.
Yeah. But I think that once it is passed, that I think we can take the pledge as an excerpt, and you know, we don't have to, when we print materials to put a handout or
it'll
put on
just the pledge.
We can just put the pledge with the seal and we can reference the resolution.
Right.
But you're right that people are not going to want to read all that arcane language every time.
Mm-hmm.
Because in reading it here, I think it reads just fine. I don't think I need to.
So does it actually need a signature bar at the very end for people to sign the pledge? How does one sign the pledge? I need a spot for it. Where do I sign?
Great question. And how do we track signatures?
Or do we track?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if we need to track this.
I don't know that we need to track people's names and addresses or identifying information, but I think it would be nice to say 600 of your fellow neighbors have signed this pledge.
How would we do that? Do we collect pledges? Do people send their pledges back in to us? How do they alert the Human Rights Commission that they have signed it?
That's exactly what we're... I'm glad you asked. That's
I
great.
I guess that would be a, where the Facebook page would be helpful, but it can also be a place where cynicism will rear its head, I suspect.
So we're talking about hard copies being in different places, and then
like the libraries,
way to do a digital thing.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there are all those programs that do petitions and things like that, so we could potentially use one of those and then just transfer the names when they come in, and just use Facebook as a place to kind of steer people to the petition. So they're not actually signing on Facebook.
Just have a link, you mean? So that everybody signed in one place? But that still wouldn't have, you know, I mean, are we gonna have it places where they can sign it around the city, though?
I think that's important for people.
I agree, but we have two different things then, but that.
But if you have a hard copy of it at Forbes Library and people can sign it,
right.
Who collects that hard copy signature and brings it, and how long do we see ourselves this sustained event? Is it a 1 year event? Is it a 1 month event? Is it a 6 month event?
And you don't want people signing more than once. Well, maybe we do, but
they're very enthusiastic.
It's not as scientific.
But you know what? At that point, I mean, why can't it just be ongoing? I mean, why does it have to have a deadline? We can have a deadline of promoting it and everything, but it should be out there all the time. I mean, new resident comes in, they should be able to sign it if they want.
But my question was only if we're tracking it, like, how long do we want to be tracking it? How old do you want to be when you're coming to this?
I don't think we can commit future members to continue.
Yeah.
My sense is I would like to propose that we call this a year of civility. And as part of asking people to sign the pledge, to encourage them to take it back to whatever communities, neighborhoods that they are connected with. There is a town in Maine where I did some work this year that has a little town named it a year of kindness. So the churches in town are doing special events to live out their expression of kindness, the library, the civic organization. So that's a way we can invite people to not only just sign, but also to embody the spirit of civility in whatever way makes sense in their context.
Which brings up the point, another place we had to approach is the churches.
What about it's gone out of my head, the place on Pleasant Street, the better...
The Chamber of Commerce.
The City Hall. I mean, I would have thought we could have had them in a number of public places.
I think that's a great idea to have it, you know, Lilly Library, Forbes Library, City Hall. Mm-hmm. I think the Chamber's a great idea. Even, I mean, there's so many, you have to figure out how you want to limit it. You know, send one to each of the churches and the synagogues and the temples, and you could put it in stores for that matter. You know, there is, it's kind of an endless, there's endless opportunity here.
Yeah, it feels like a kind of knitting together of the community. So, yes. Sort of the more places it is, it feels to me the better. And hopefully the schools.
It's just the question is how much legwork, you know, people want to commit to. Because I was imagining a way to kind of do it technically, I suppose, is, or logistically, if the word, is to maybe have a self-addressed stamped envelope attached to, you know, 6 pages worth or something and give them out and talk to somebody that becomes responsible for it at the chamber or at a store or wherever it may be. And at a certain point, you know, 5 months down the line, 6 months down the line, we'd ask them to send in what they have with their self-addressed stamped envelope or something like that.
A physical piece of paper where a person has signed the pledge. That's what we're talking about, is collecting the actual pledge.
The signature page, I was thinking, for the hard copies.
Because I would like people to keep their copy of their civility pledge. If there's kids in school, they have it. I don't want them to sign it and send it back to us. I want them to have it and read it.
A signature page, but give out like a you know, quarter page or a third page, you know, for people to keep.
This is just the grammar stuff. Just rereading it. It needs a tiny bit of work on the grammar of the pledge, from what we've got, you know, from what went out today. Refrain from, I pledge to support a civil offender by refraining from disparaging other people based on who they are. And I'm not quite sure what the next bit means. And by attending by those. By attending to those who are the targets of such acts. That's part of the big principle. That's it, this one.
I suspect we might need a work day that we set aside as a group. If we're all here, can we do that? If it's advertised?
What do you mean, for what?
To get copies, send them out in envelopes, decide what we're going to do, like actually the distribution, a distribution day.
I'm wondering if around town, too, we could put up QR codes, the ones where they just take their phone and then it links them to a website, they can read it and sign right then and there, so that way we're able to post it around town and it doesn't have to be the full pledge and they can just use their phones to find it.
That simple?
Yeah, it's just like, you just download
like
the QR
app. Way over my head.
All you do is hold it above. It's like a little square. You hold
yeah,
it
but I didn't
square.
Know, how do you get that QR code?
The QR code, you can go on a website and it'll just generate it for you. So you give them the link.
Really?
And they'll make it in 2 seconds, yeah. So you don't have to do any work for it.
Oh my God.
And this is called something I've heard of before, but not this called.
The QR code?
Oh, I've seen
QR
that.
Code.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just didn't know. I never
like,
realized
can,
how
can
you got one.
Did you do that? Yeah.
I mean, I've done it before with that, but I've never realized how you, I thought it was a lot more difficult.
No, there's so many websites. You just go right
really?
On, give them the link, and they make
oh
it for
God.
You.
It's like Bitly
yeah.
one of those things that also reduces
I'm so
websites.
Old.
Vignette still filled with wonder.
Yeah. Yeah, well, kind of the circle of life, you know. There's things I'm wondering about that I really shouldn't.
So, can someone answer my technical question? Can we have a work day if we announce it publicly?
And record it, yeah.
And record it.
And what would you want to do on the work day?
Distribute this alleged pledge.
Well, how do you record it if you're distributing it?
We would just
you have a launch kind of thing.
Yeah, a launch party.
It has to be open to the public too.
Yeah. And then we'd stride out with a proclamation.
We could choose a date in September, look up and see if there are any sort of national days of that make sense to target. We could just stand on the steps of City Hall and
we have our shirts.
We have our shirts.
We do.
And we have the park that's in the front. Yeah.
We do, yeah.
That might not be there much longer though.
Oh yeah.
It's just a demo park.
So to answer your question, I think, yes, we have to target some day where it goes live. You know, often with projects, there's sort of a soft open where we would ask folks in advance to commit to either having the pledges available or to, you know, some high-profile people who are willing to put their names on it as well, and then the major, you know, the launch.
Yeah,
the
launch party.
Yeah. But yes. So I think that would be in September. Hopefully people are back from their summer vacations by then.
So when would our meeting be in September?
Our regular meeting in September would be the 27th. Fourth Wednesday.
Yeah, 27th.
Another little grammatical thing.
Mm-hmm.
The second to last, be it further resolved, it says that if we witness such incidents, we will not ignore it, but because incidents is plural,
oh, right.
To be
yes.
Them. So.
Thank you.
And we like read this over 28 times and we still find problems.
How do we envision a launch party in an afternoon after work on a Saturday morning? How do we see this?
Is this our last meeting before our launch?
There's a July meeting and an August meeting.
So there is an August meeting too.
Unless I look briefly at people's away schedule and I think we'll continue to have a quorum for both months. I will not be here in July, but Laura will be chairing.
I will be here in July.
What do you think people's preferences are for a launch party? A Saturday morning in September? Noon to two, something like that, a 2 hour kind of window on a Saturday?
Just have to make sure that you can get into a city building.
Why?
Because if Saturday they might be closed.
Why do we need to get into the building?
Because it has to be be open to the public and recorded.
Is outdoors considered open to the public, or do we need a restroom and a, as if we did on the steps of City Hall? Is that considered open to the public?
We're talking about the launch itself.
Mm-hmm.
You can do that anywhere, but if it's like a meeting where you're preparing things and doing things?
No, we're talking about actually.
Oh, I thought you were talking
about putting it all together.
Yeah.
I think that in the August meeting, you could potentially have it printed and make lists.
Yes.
And then in September, we would be literally standing on City Hall, handing it out, and if that's publicized and is open to the public.
Oh yeah, that's totally
fine.
Okay. Yeah, it's like when the Human Rights Commission used to do Human Rights Day and do a big event and some kind of event. It's working meetings where you're like deliberating and planning and that kind of stuff needs to be kind of documented and so forth.
Mm-hmm. I think when it would be, if we want to say we're encouraging a year of civility or celebrating a year in support culture of civility, it would be nice if we could accompany that with some materials about, with some suggestions of how you can promote civility in your neighborhoods, homes, schools. So I think it would be helpful if we had a subcommittee of people to work on that. If we think that's a good idea.
It also seems important. I mean, are you talking about that being an ally? Of, you know, especially because of what happened in court.
Providing people, like having something to provide, here's ways you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you're talking about?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and having some sort of a handout of ways to promote civility or, okay.
I'm happy to work on that, on those ideas.
I mean, I'll be happy to work on it too. I'm just going to be out a lot in July. I'll be out of town a lot in July and August. So, but I'll be more than happy to try and find some time.
Okay. Elisa, what is the, this is kind of arcane, I don't know if you know this, but a shared Google Doc for the commission, is that considered, would that be considered a violation if there was a shared Google Doc for everyone to contribute to?
Unless
I think of crushing shared Google Docs. I don't think you can do that. Because you have to announce the date and the time.
I was thinking if commissioners wanted to just offer ideas of ways in which people could take the pledge into their lives.
But because of open meeting law, don't we have to do it more publicly?
You were talking about having it for people to sign?
No,
I was thinking
if commissioners had ideas for how people in the public could take this pledge into their
lives. Oh yeah, that would
lives.
Totally be considered deliberation. Yeah.
I'm just a technical point, again, I'll bring us back to this. After I read the pledge, I want to be able to say, I, Christine Young, hereby sign this pledge. I need a signature line. I need to know what I'm pledging to do. The date, it needs a minimum of a signature line and a date and...
I think you should probably also have a printed name.
Yeah.
These are kind of situations in which you sign, then you print your name, and that is a date. I would have thought.
And some instructions, what to do with this. If I'm at Forbes Library, mm-hmm. and there's a hard copy, and I want to sign it, but you're saying just a bunch of signature pages.
Well, I think the pledge is at the top of the page, and next to it are the pledge itself, multiple copies, so people can take one with them. But it would be a signature page so you could sign below the pledge on one page, and those are the pages we would get back, and
only
we would hope that people would take away with them copies.
But I would also like people to know that we're not actually collecting the names. We're not really interested in having people print their name and see it. I don't really want to track people who have signed this.
No. Except don't you want them to be Northampton residents? Really?
I don't. I want people to embrace a culture of civility, no matter if they're visiting here or here for dinner or just at Forbes Library getting a book.
So it would be more like, you know, 2,033 people have signed Northampton's civility
right.
pledge.
Right.
So it wouldn't necessarily be residents of Northampton.
Yeah. I mean, I think the other thing about that is it makes you vulnerable to sort of make up people. I mean, they're right. I mean, I don't know whether there's a danger about that.
I think there's also power in being able to say, you know, this many Northampton residents have endorsed this personally, but that, you know, it's just my opinion.
Well, I think both are true, and which do we want to go?
Well, you could put a checkbox on the signature page that says, do you live in Northampton? Mm-hmm. If for some reason we were curious of where people live who signed the civility pledge.
Maybe we're just thinking too much. I mean, maybe we could just be conveniently naive and assume they're Northampton residents. I mean, the point is, what I'd like to do is I want to leave those signatures there for as long as we can, because I think it has a lot of power, people looking there and seeing it and seeing a ton of signatures.
Or not. Well, what if there's only five?
I think that's just as important. I mean, that would be worrisome. I mean, that would be, you know, but I don't think, I would just assume that it's in the city of Northampton, that they're Northampton residents, and I don't want to exclude somebody that's not, but I don't necessarily care.
The resolution does call on all people in the Northampton community, but that's not explicit in the pledge itself.
The other thing that could be done, I suppose, is change the wording of the pledge and have something like, as a resident of the city of Northampton, I stand against, or not stand, sorry, I am against, and then start the, what we have, mm-hmm. bias incidents, acts of injustice, so that it necessarily kind of means those who are signing it are Northampton residents. But you're saying something different, it sounds like, Chris, that you know, you would like anybody who comes across this to be willing to sign it and support it, no?
Well, I do believe that, because I think we happen to be a city that gets a lot of visitors every single day of the year. There are people visiting here and supporting our city financially and other ways, and if they would like to sign a civility pledge, I welcome their acknowledgement. It doesn't cost anything, and it doesn't cost us anything to have non-residents sign it.
And it possibly sort of spreads it out further, which we'd like to encourage.
If prior to the pledge we have an introductory sentence that says, as a member of the Northampton community, I blank support the culture of civility in Northampton, it allows people to self-identify if they consider themselves a member of the community.
Well, and that's the important thing. I mean, for many years, I didn't live in Northampton, but I was here every single weekend. I was here, I felt a member of the community. I live here.
Yeah, I like that. That's a good way to handle that. But write it into the pledge itself, right?
I'm so glad we voted on the pledge.
I know.
When we first got here.
I think before we finish, I'm going to ask for the commission's authority to, or authorization for me to make whatever tweaks I need to do in order to get it in the right form for the city council. I'm taking off. It's a good thing I'm note taker this week.
No.
How would we, are you on the subcommittee going to design the Facebook page?
There's, the city government does not encourage individuals, committees or commissions to have their own Facebook pages. However,
this is for specific.
This is for a specific.
No, I can't imagine.
Period of time. Right.
It's for a specific
period of time. We're not going to continue to collect the pledges forever.
But also, it's not like an ongoing page of the Human Rights Commission. It's like a campaign
right.
of the commission.
The Year of Civility from September 2017 to September 2018. Is the launch of it. We see civility as forever, but this is
the campaign.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I'd be happy to help you in August. I can't
okay.
do it until
mm-hmm. Yeah, August is a bit better.
Okay.
I also remember last meeting the subcommittee was brought up, and I know a few people had said they didn't want us to do any more subcommittee meetings. I just remember that from last meeting, just to
okay.
throw out there as a reminder.
Right. It may be that we can just identify tasks that we don't need to have a subcommittee to work on. We can just have the individuals working on the tasks.
I mean, I'm fine with you. I just remember people
thank you
that
for raising that.
Yeah.
Okay. And we have almost half of our votes not here, so I'm mindful of that as well.
I think you'd be very useful because you know things the rest of us don't. The secret world.
She's a digital native.
So the things that we need to have in place before September are the actual physical cards and hard copies of the pledge, of the resolution and the pledge. We don't have a budget.
That's what I was gonna ask.
I think it's generational to have a hard copy, now that I hear about Q9.
You are. The hard copies would be the things that are placed in City Hall and at Forbes mm-hmm. Library, and et cetera, et cetera.
So I guess in the instructions that go near the pledge, it would be some sort of encouragement for people to sign and be counted. So the Human Rights Commission is interested in how many people sign this during the first year. Mm-hmm. I would do one count, 1 year. I wouldn't make ourselves crazy with anything more, any more data than that. Do we know how many people live in Northampton?
28,000.
So we get to say on the instructions, there are 28,000 people who are counted in the census in Northampton. How many have signed in 1 year?
Does that include Florence and Leeds, right?
Yes.
It's a long time before we can say X number of people voted. And that's one thing in terms of having this ongoing kind of
I will look into something along the lines of an online petition site that we could use to have people sign digitally. Once we get that, I can make a QR code for it. And I'll ask the mayor about the Facebook campaign. If anyone has any particular skill in branding and would like to help design design the cards,
I would like Carlos' friend to help us.
That would be great.
Can we use our shirt design?
I think, just really quickly, one of the things to ask the mayor is if we can use the city seal on it.
Yes. Yeah.
Sorry.
I like our t-shirt. We already have a brand. And it's sort of an inclusive design.
Make sure that I give Lori an update on these things before the July meeting, and then you all can take whatever next steps have to happen at that. Any other, do I have your authorization to make whatever tweaks necessary to get this resolution in its form?
Only if you promise to never bring it back anymore.
I'm reluctant to make a definitive promise, but I will do
I was
everything possible to not bring it back to you. All right, so our next item on the agenda is, I don't know if all of you saw, there were two articles in the Gazette last week about students who protested their experience of sexual harassment at the middle school, and I drafted a letter on behalf of the commission and pose it to you all.
Can you, for, I did not see the articles, I briefly heard about it, so if you could, because there's a couple things in here that directly related
yes.
to it, so if you can kind of.
Sure, there were a group of students that sat in the hall outside the classrooms in JFK Middle School holding signs to draw attention to the existence of sexual harassment in the school. And
by who?
Fellow students.
Okay.
Fellow students. And yeah, and there are some stories that were shared in the newspaper that were their descriptions of how that was handled in the school. On the last day of school, there's traditionally a picnic at Look Park, and a small number of students who were walking from JFK to Look Park carried signs with them as they went over there. So both of those were covered in the newspaper. The principal, after the first demonstration, met with the student organizers in her office and spoke about how they could.
Were they disciplined at all?
It was not mentioned in the newspaper. I'm not sure if they were or not.
Okay, that's right.
Right. I don't know if they were or not, but if they were, that's something that activists, that's what that happens when you make it not sit down or stand up for justice. So I did this without having the opportunity to consult with you all, and so this is our first time together questioning when is it appropriate for us to step into happenings in the community, and how comfortable are you with this, and should we proceed, or are there not enough of us here for people to feel comfortable moving forward?
Quorum is a quorum.
I love it, but that's just me. I think it's great. I really. I just think it's, you know, it's not threatening or anything. It's just saying, hey, listen, you know, certain students recognize a problem and we need to just make sure that their concerns are addressed and we support them for it. I particularly like that, you know, the comment about that, you know, the took courage for the students to make themselves visible in the community of their peers. It does. That takes a lot of courage.
Especially in middle school.
It's an exact action of our civility pledge, which is that people don't stand by when people are harmed in our community.
I felt that it was within the strategies that are available to us, which is to name and celebrate examples of people standing up for, or people honoring human rights and advocating for human rights in our community.
The only question I have, and I don't necessarily have a problem, but I think it probably is, the ones that, if the participating students are disciplined for their actions, that almost sounds like a threat. That's the only thing. You know, I don't know, the first time I read it, I felt like somebody going, if they're disciplined for their actions.
Yeah, no,
No, but the rest of the sentence says.
Exactly. I don't have a problem with the rest of the sentence. I think it does that. That would be the only one where, the only thing where I don't know, could it be reworded or something?
I wonder if it'd be possible to write if the participating students
you flip
experience consequences for their actions?
You flip the sentence and you say, there is a long history of advocates being disciplined for their actions.
Or experiencing consequences.
Mm-hmm.
Because it isn't every, I mean, it could be a whole lot of things.
Right.
Not just discipline.
If you say experience consequences for their action, that, to me, that's a little less threatening. I don't know, it's
mm-hmm.
just me though.
But it also talks about how their peers might respond, as well as the administration. I have one small grammar thing.
We could take out the if and say the participating students may experience consequences for their actions.
We applaud them for following a long history of the advocates before them.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with the sentence completely.
Yeah.
I just don't want them to pull that one sentence out and feel
I
like...
I want it to be positive.
Exactly.
I want to applaud them.
When you word the word disciplined, it just, to
yes.
me, it,
mm-hmm.
it's a threatening thing.
Yep.
I would have said that, it might be good to write, the participating students follow a long history of advocates before them.
Mm-hmm.
Something about the consequences of their actions.
It's not about the consequences. I'm applauding the fact that they made this public and that they
right.
that they've done a wonderful service.
And if there's any consequences, so be it. Yeah, I mean, good.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm not disagreeing
so
with
it,
you.
Yeah.
I'm not disagreeing
yeah.
with you at all. But how
do you feel about this? The participating students follow a long history of advocates before them. Who take action regardless of
consequences.
Yes.
Possibly facing consequences.
Yes.
I like that
something
because
like
that's not.
Yes, because it.
Maybe it's just taking the if out of
yes,
it.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. I also think
it might be its own sentence too, and you're not linking it with the principal and the provost. And
exactly.
All that.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, yeah, that's true.
Yes.
So you might tuck it in at the end that says that we're sort of applauding it.
Or I may put it at the end of the paragraph before that starts with the courage that it took
mm-hmm.
them.
Yeah.
Yes.
Seems to fit there.
And I think the fourth line, in doing so, they were exercising the rights the United Nations codified.
Thank you.
Now, will this be signed, the Human Rights Commission?
I think it has to, I presume it has to have people.
I think I will use my name and chair on behalf of the Human Rights Commission.
They don't like to have, the Gazette wants one signature and then it's set. They put a little like byline below the signature that says, these are the members of the Human Rights Commission with the names. All contributed to this, something that they have some language that they use.
That they want all the names on there?
I think you would want all the names
on there. Oh, I would.
That.
That's what I'm saying. I think we should. I would. I'd like my name
or,
on there. But
or they write something like this was signed by all of the members of the Human Rights Commission.
And then list the names.
There.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think that's important.
I just want to say how much I appreciate you getting right on it. And coming up with this so quickly.
I agree, thank you.
Yeah.
And I love the way it's concise and supportive and right to the point.
Completely within our purview.
So
yes.
I would make a motion to approve the letter with the changes. Approve the letter to the editor, or, you know, with a letter with the changes. With respect to the JFK Middle School protest events, incident.
Great.
A second. Thank you.
And the very last word, of course, needs to be said.
Oh, yeah, that was the thing. Yeah, very last word.
Sorry.
I was reading Moresso, and I'm going, what is Moresso?
Thank you.
There's one other grammar thing that I saw, but now I have to remember just now.
the numbering that I saw something. There's a word missing, like a little tiny preposition word.
A particle or participle.
We affirmed that it took courage?
No, we affirmed the courage it took these students, yeah. I think that's all right.
Just awkward.
Targets of sexual harassment may be just any gender, race, class. It doesn't have to be maybe of any gender, race, or class. I think, and as it is, I think it's fine.
Maybe of.
I don't know. I can't decide.
Does that? We also recognize that even Paradise City is not perfect. Does that sound right? It's not the Paradise City. Okay. You were thinking the United Nations thing too.
Oh, the rights of the United Nations, you guys talked about that? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep, I probably wasn't.
Okay. All right, so we have a motion and it's been seconded and discussed. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposition? Abstention? Okay, thank you. I will send that out tomorrow. I can also ask Alyssa to, when it's been set, we can ask Alyssa to put a copy of this on the city's website. Facebook page.
Do you need the okay to put the other Human Rights Commission's names on there since they were here?
That's a great question.
What's the practice of this body?
Well, as a quorum, you've made decisions on behalf of the commission.
Right, we've made lots of decisions signed on behalf of people who aren't here.
I think everything that went out before were things written by Natalia, and then there was a decision, there was never a kind of consensus, and so people chose not to be listed. So I think it's up to us to make that decision. I don't think there's a precedent for, is my memory anyway, of how it unfolded in the past.
Well, actually, what you're describing is a precedent where it was only the chairperson's name is actually the precedent.
But that was specifically because
to
the
that
members
president.
Chose, yeah, not to, but I think the members, it's up to the members to choose, the current members to choose how they want.
Can you ask that in an email, or is that deliberation?
You mean to ask the others if they want their name on?
I think you could ask the individual members, because it's not exactly deliberation, it's just asking them if they want to be signed on.
I think it's important to do that. I think you want to say yay or nay to having your name on the letter.
I think that it should be written in this fashion. It is the custom of this board to have a letter written by the chair and signed by all members. If you don't wish to have your name added, then that would be what it is. Because I would like this to be the practice in the future. If I'm not here and the commission votes on a letter, I would like that to be our practice. Because it's an awful lot of work for a small board to be chasing people down every time we want to do something, particularly if we want it to be timely.
I agree.
I think that I will ask those few people who aren't here tonight specifically, and I will add that Lori has given her assent. And I will ask that be part of the July board meeting so that other people can
codify that. Yeah.
Can decide if that's how they actually want it to be forward. Any new business to come before the commission tonight? Entertain a motion to adjourn early. Surprise, surprise.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Move early. All right. Thank you all.
Thank you.